You all must be wondering why there is nobody in front of the screen. But I know you all are doing great. And this time, Live Your Passion, your channel, has come up with a passion story about writing. When and how it started. It started with me, Abhishek. When I was 12 years old, and first time when I laid my hand on Animal Vespa, two-stroke scooter, which my dad used to own. It was one of the legendary scooters during those days, along with Bajaj Chetak. With the help of my elder brother, I started riding. My brother used to tell me, Sonu, I forgot to tell you that my nickname is Sonu. So he used to tell me, Sonu, when dad is sleeping, you go and you know, slowly take out the keys from his pocket. Then in turn he'll ride and he's going to let me know the scheme of riding. So it all started and I was 12 years old. And you know, when you are 12 years old and if you're going to sit on the seat of a scooter, then your feet are not going to touch the bottom. So I used to stand and ride. It was all fun and my brother used to be a comedian. And thereafter, when my brother started earning, he bought an Aluminum Legend. It was the first four-stroke scooter in India. Maybe I'm wrong, but as far as my knowledge goes, I think it was the first four-stroke scooter in India. And it was butter smooth. So, below the age of 18, I started traveling to localities to buy stuff from here and there. And you know, when you're young and you're fond of something, if you get the things which you love doing. So every time you ask, you know, your brother or maybe your dad, that key is, you know, because I want to go and buy it. So it all started. Then my second brother, after my elder brother, when he started running, he went for a second-hand Yamaha RX-100. When I'm talking about RX-100, you all know what I'm talking about. Because still late, it is a benchmark in 100cc category. And the time when I laid my hand on Yamaha, since then I'm a great fan of Yamaha. And later on when I started earning, after my 2 months of salary, I went for a bike. But my mom insisted, you know, not to go for two-wheelers. You know, I should wait and go for four-wheelers. Because we all know that our parents are concerned about us and they don't want the children to go for two-wheelers because it's a bit of risky proposition, right? But still I went for it. And in those days, Bajaj was the name in the market. Bajaj Pulsar 150 cc. And in those years, Yamaha came up with every system, but as Yamaha was not doing great in India, so you know, I decided to go for Bajaj because it was the hype during those days. So I went for Bajaj 150cc, and the guy whom I booked it, he delivered it in my office, and I called up my mom. I said, "Mom, you get ready because after office I'll come. And I'm going to take you along with me on this new bike to do the rituals." Like we Hindus, whenever we buy something new, so we go for rituals, the religious ritual, that we take our bike or else the car to the temple and we follow the rituals. So I took my mom along with me and she really enjoyed it. You know, earlier she was telling me not to go for it, but you know, after the try, she said, "Wow, what a bike." And after running that bike for around 3 years, I decided that the time has come for me to alter it. So I wanted to go for a Pulsar 220, but my friend Shyam, who owns a garage and he does all the modifications, so he said, "Abhishek, why don't you want to stick to another brand?" So I said, "Which one?" He said, "Try Yamaha R15. So then I went to the Yamaha showroom. I saw R15 and a spark generated inside me. and I decided that I have to go for Yamaha R1 bike. But the colors which were attracting me were yellow and white combination. It was too aggressive. Cherry red was amazing. But you know, after giving a thought for around 2 minutes, I decided, because I'm fond of black, maybe if I'm going to go something apart from black, I may like it for 2 months, but later on, you know, I will again come back to black. So I decided to go for black. So with that Yamaha R15, I made my first trip along with my office colleague. One of my colleague, he bought a Royal Enfield Classic 500. He booked it here in Kolkata, but unfortunately, during those days, the waiting period was around 6 months. So he called up Delhi, and in Delhi, he found that the bike was available. So he transferred the money there, he cancelled the booking here in Kolkata, and with the help of the logistic, he brought it here in Kolkata, then he registered it. So it was all the mix bike for the trust trip, for the first trip that we went. It was to a place called Tajpur. And the combinations were R15, my friend was in Royal Enfield Classic 500, another friend of mine was in Discover 135cc, and the another one was in Passion Pro. We really enjoyed that trip, which is a sea beach in Tajpur. It's around 180 kilometers from Kolkata. So we really enjoyed it. So it was the first time. So thereafter, I always used to think, you know, that I should go for trips. But after that, I used to go for small rides, you know, 70, 80 kilometers to a place called Kulaghat. There is a famous dhaba called Sher e Punjab, along with my friends, just for a tea or break, something like that. But you know, never on a trip. And it was always like a one day, going for breakfast or else going for lunch, that kind of thing. But when you cross the age of 30, and then you feel that, you know, it is difficult for you to couch and ride, because when I'm talking about Yamaha R15, it is basically falling under the sports segment, and you have to couch and ride. So then I decided it's time for me to leave my R15. So then, you know, after going through multiple reviews, because I was looking for something which, you know, I can ride it with a much powerful engine. So then I decided to go for Royal Enfield Himalayan. And as per the review which was given by Royal Enfield, they said that they have tested their bike in different terrains, in mountain, in Himalayas, in off-roading. So like, I was never a fan of Royal Enfield, but this time, because of the different kind of bike, I decided to go for it. So I went for Royal Enfield Himalayan, and I believe I was the first customer in Kolkata, and it was launched on 16th of June if I'm not wrong. So I went for a test ride on that day, immediately transferred the amount. Thereafter, you know, after receiving it, I got a call from Royal Enfield showroom, and I think they have a target that they have to organize around 7 to 11 number of trips in a year. So then I got a call. Then they chose a place called Mandamani, which is again a sea beach. So I went along with the Royal Enfield group altogether. But you know, they were not organizing the trips every now and then. So then, you know, with that group, because the group were very active, so we decided, the members of the group, we only decided to have a different group outside the Royal Enfield. And we came up with a group called RE Riders, Royal Enfield Riders. And we then decided not to go for 200 or 300 kilometers, and we decided straight away to hit something around 700 kilometers to, you know, set a kind of benchmark for our riders who are new into the field. So we decided a destination called Benares. Trust me, we enjoyed it a lot. We started 5:30 in the morning. We reached there at around 9:30, and the journey was really amazing. We spent around 4 days of good times there. And since then, you know, I must say, with the help of Royal Enfield, then I decided to cover here and there. But as it was the new launch product in the market, so it started giving me issues. So then I thought of, if they were Royal Enfield, so you should have another bike, a reliable one. Sorry to say, but I'm talking about a reliable one. So then, you know, after scrutiny, when after scrutiny and all, then I decided to go for Yamaha FC25, which is not a trip-ready bike, which is actually meant for city. But because of my Royal Enfield Himalayan, which is most of the time in the service center because of the issues which is there, I think we all know if you are, if you keep a news of bikes and all. So it is still there in the service center since last 2 months. And I must say, in a span of 1.5 years, for around 4 to 5 months, my bike was there in service center only. So I will be getting it delivered soon because they have done whatever was under warranty. So again, I can take it on my trip. So for these trips and all, you know, I keep myself fit because it is important, I believe, because, you know, if you cover distances, so you have to keep yourself fit. And I love riding and I'm very passionate about it. So whatever is required, I do it. And I follow a good diet so that I keep myself fit. And I also believe, you know, like the things which we love doing, we should go for it. And whatever is required, we should do it. So this is just a small passion story about mine. And, you know, I request you all, if you love something, if you love doing something, then you should go for it. Because tomorrow you should not regret that you could have done something but you have missed it. If you know what your passion is, so you should go for it. So this is just a small story about my passion story. So here I've shared it with you. I hope you all will like this video and will share with others so that they can also have a look and they will come up with their own passion story. So be fit and keep your passion alive and live your passion.